Hey everybody, it's Pastor Mike, and I just want to say, Happy Easter everybody! And while I don't get to see you guys in person, because of course we're still in that quarantine thing, we are so blessed to still be able to come to you with a video. So, we have a lot of really cool, important things today. We have some special guests lined up for you today. We've got Chuck the Duck. Who's Chuck the Duck? Well, we're going to find out. We also have a scavenger hunt for you today. So be ready. Get ready to pop up on your toes and go find things. And also, we have some worship songs. So with all that, it's Happy Easter. And Easter is a very important, special day. Why? Because it's the day that we celebrate that Jesus died for us. And he came back. He came back for us so that we could find ourselves in heaven forever with Jesus. How cool is that, isn't it? Okay, so since it's Easter, and because it's our Easter service video for you guys, it's, what's always important is we get to worship and sing and sing praises to God. And how cool and how fun is singing and dancing to worship music. So we've got some songs for you today. And the first one is called Echo by Hillsong. So who's ready to do some worship music today, huh? I can't hear you. Oh, all right. That sounds like you guys are ready. So get up. Let's stretch. All right. Let's get our stretch on. Let's get our muscles stretched out. And let's get ready to worship. Here we go. It's song one, guys. Let's do it.
When night has fallen, fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided.
Yeah.
wow, that was really cool song. I love that one. And we always know what? That Jesus never lets go of us. And that when we love him and follow him, he bursts out of us like an echo. It's so cool. And that's what Jesus is. He never lets go, and he always loves us. But, you know, I'm not feeling tired enough yet. I still feel some energy. Do you feel some energy? I'm telling you what. I think we should listen to another worship song. Who wants to listen to another one? I know I do. And I could even see Maddie over there as she's watching. She's dancing. So for that, let's go ahead and do one more song before we get on with our special guest. Let's listen to the next song. Are you guys ready? Get back up on your feet and let's do one more. Let's get dancing.
My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. So mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do.
Wow, what a cool song. I love that. That was a good cartoon, too. It was fun to watch. But you know what? Now we get to get on to a cool part. We've got some special guests that are here to help us today and celebrate Easter with us. And we've got some games for you. The first activity we're going to do today is, you know, there's something that we usually do on Easter that is really fun. What is it? Can you guys think of something? What could it possibly be? Is it go to the movies? No, you're right. It's not it. That is it, scavenger hunts? Yeah, that's what it is, scavenger hunts. So why don't we do our own scavenger hunt? In fact, we've got a special guest who's got a really cool scavenger hunt. So get up on your feet, be ready to go find some stuff. And what do you say we get started? Here we go. Let's cheer on our special guest and the special game he has for us. And he has a special treat at the very end. Something awesome. It's a big reveal. So here we go.
Well, hello there, boys and girls. I'm Pastor Victor, and welcome to Find the Items. Today, I need your help. I need your help to reveal today's power verse. As you can see, we have 6 peeps behind us. We need to eat every single peep. I love peeps. Well, sometimes they're kind of too fluffy for me to eat. You know what I'm saying? But I need your help. So we gotta go find the items. Go grab your mom, go grab your dad, or whoever's around to help you help me find the items. Here we go. Our first item is, oh man, we gotta go find a Bible. Go find a Bible now, go. Hey, did you find a Bible? And if you didn't, I did for you. Boom. Check it out, got the Bible for you. All right. So, our next item is, all right. Our next item will be, find a roll of toilet paper. Go! All right, did you find a roll of toilet paper? You know where the toilet paper's at. If you didn't, I got one for you. Yeah, these are so valuable right now, but whatever. But look, all right, we're almost there. We're revealing the power verse together. This is amazing. Thank you so much, boys and girls. Let's see what our next peep is all about. Our next peep says, oh man, we have to go find a toothbrush. You know where that is. Go! Hey, did you find a toothbrush? Come on, you know where that's at. You can't find it. Don't worry, I got your back. Hold on, let's see. I got a toothbrush for you. Look! Not time to brush right now. Okay, so you found the toothbrush. Good job. We're almost there. We're almost done with the last couple of peeps, and we're gonna get to see the power verse for today. All right, our next item is, oh, we gotta go find a family photo. Go! Did you find the family photo? You did? Good job. I did too. Check this out. I got one too. Look, my beautiful family. I love my family. You love your family? I love my family, but not now, okay? It's time to continue to complete this awesome Find the Items challenge. We're almost there. We got two more peeps left. Two delicious peeps. All right, here we go. Here is our next item to look for. Oh, we gotta go look for a toy. Go find a toy now. Hey, did you find a toy? You did? All right. Wait, you did it? You don't know. Does a dog count? A dog counts. Don't worry, a dog counts. If you didn't, I have a toy for you. Check it out. Okay, no time for that either. Okay, we got one more delicious peep left. Are you excited? Can you feel the excitement right now? We got one more peep. All right, the final peep is, oh, we gotta go find some keys. You know where those things are. Go! Did you get the keys? Yeah, buddy, you got the keys. Well, I did too, look. Bam! It's time to go on an adventure. Adventure. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Now look, we have completed the power verse. I want you to get up and do a little dance for me. Come on. Yeah. We just completed the power verse. Yeah. Congratulations, boys and girls. We just completed our power verse. Thank you so much for helping me find the items. Now let's go over this power verse. Our power verse says, because I live, you also will live. John 14:19. All right, boys and girls, now I want you to repeat after me. Let's do this. Because I live, you also will live. John 14:19. Awesome job. Let's do it one more time. This time, get your mom and dad to say it with you or whoever's around. Ready? Here we go. Because I live, you also will live. John 14:19. Thank you, boys and girls, for helping me complete today's power verse. I appreciate it so much. You were a big help. Now it's time for you to get back to your lesson. Peace out.
How cool was that? We did a scavenger hunt, and when we did, we were able to find a Bible verse. And what was the Bible verse? The Bible verse was John 14:19, where it says, because I live, you also will live. What great news is that? What a cool game, and what a cool Bible verse that we got to find together. Now, we have another special guest, and you know, he has a very cool story to tell, and he's going to share it with us. Have you ever been on a scavenger hunt where you trip and fall? I've never heard of this before, but some people have actually fallen and gotten stuck inside an egg. How does that happen? I have no idea, but we have a special guest today, and he is called, his name is Chuck the Duck, and he is going to tell us exactly how that happened. Are you guys ready to hear the story? I'm ready to hear the story. Let's get ready. Are you ready? All right, here's Chuck the Duck.
Hey everyone, I'm John McLennan, and this is my good friend Chuck the Duck.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Good to see you. You're looking good.
Well, Chuck, something looks a little off with you today.
Well, something's always a little off with you, dude.
Okay, no, I mean how you're sitting.
What do you mean?
It looks like you're sitting in a giant Easter egg.
Oh, yeah, I didn't think you'd notice. It's kind of embarrassing.
Embarrassing? How's that?
Well,
what?
I said, I'm stuck.
You're stuck?
Shh, don't tell the whole world.
Well, it's kind of funny.
It's not funny.
Okay, well, what happened? How did you get into this mess?
Well, I was out looking for some Easter candy, and I saw this bunny rabbit. And he invited me to come sit in this Easter egg. He said it'd be real comfortable.
Okay.
So I sat in it for a while, then I realized I was stuck.
Well, that's not a very good Easter prank.
No, it's not, and I also realized I need to lose some weight.
Okay. Well, Chuck, what are you going to do to get out of this mess?
Well, I was looking for Jesus.
For Jesus?
Yep.
Why is that?
Well, I read that he's an escape artist.
An escape artist?
Yep.
Like a magician?
Yep. He escaped from a tomb on Easter Sunday. Maybe at that door, or...
No. Chuck... Jesus is not a magician.
Are you kidding me?
No, I mean, God raised him from the dead.
Oh, so God is the magician.
No, Chuck, let me explain it to you. The Bible says that Jesus came and he died on the cross for our sins. And he was buried according to the scriptures. And 3 days later, God raised him from the dead and rolled away the stone of the tomb. And Jesus is alive and free.
Wow. Raised from the dead?
Yes, it's an amazing true story that we find in the Bible.
Wow, well, what do you know about that? So do you think Jesus can help me?
You mean help you out of this Easter egg?
No, to find candy, yes, to get out of this egg.
Okay, well, I can help you with that. But boys and girls, we want you to know that Jesus is there to help you. And the Bible says that because he is alive, we can live with him if we put our trust in him.
Well, I trust Jesus every day.
Well, that's good.
You, not so much.
Okay.
But I trust Jesus.
Well, that's good. Well, boys and girls, before we go, and I need to help Chuck get out of this egg, we just want to wish you a happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
All right. Well, let's go.
What about the candy?
No, never mind the candy.
I gotta go potty.
Okay, we gotta get you out of this egg.
Wow, Chuck the Duck, what a cool dude, huh? I still don't, that was really funny though. He got stuck in an egg, can you believe that? But Jesus is the one who can get him out of it, because Jesus gets us out of all kinds of stuff. In fact, he got us out of all of our sins by dying on the cross. And we're so thankful for that. And why? Because Jesus loves us. Now, we've heard about Jesus, and we've heard about the things he did, but we actually have a cartoon for you that's going to show you the story. Are you ready to see the story of Jesus Christ and what he did for us? I'm ready. It is really cool. I've seen it, and it is really cool to watch. So how about we watch it together? Are you guys ready? I'm ready. Let's do it.
The story of Easter. Jesus' sacrifice. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
The Jewish leaders and teachers did not like what Jesus was doing or how he claimed to be the Son of God. And so they made a plan to arrest him to get rid of him once and for all. Judas, one of Jesus' disciples, agreed to betray Jesus.
Come in.
And give him over to the religious leaders for some money. Jesus was in a garden praying, and Judas showed the man who Jesus was. Jesus was arrested and taken to the rulers of the land so that they could decide what to do with him. Jesus was presented before the high council, and they asked him if he was the Messiah, the Savior of the Jews. They asked him if he was claiming to be the Son of God. You say that I am. And the council was furious, and they shouted that Jesus was guilty and he deserves to die. So they took Jesus before the Roman ruler Pilate, and he heard the case against Jesus. Pilate didn't think that Jesus had done anything wrong.
Seems okay to me.
They found him to be innocent, so Pilate said that he would punish Jesus and then release him.
What?
But the crowd kept screaming louder and louder, "Crucify him! We want him dead!" And because of the pressure of the crowd, Pilate turned Jesus over to the Roman soldiers to be crucified. Jesus was hurt and spit on, his clothes were torn and taken from him, and a crown made out of thorns was put on his head. He was beaten so badly that he could barely stand on his own. And then he was forced to carry his cross so far up a mountain that he needed help because he could not do it on his own. Once Jesus made it to the place where he would be crucified, called the Skull, the soldiers around him nailed him to the cross and waited for him to die. While Jesus was hanging on the cross, many people shouted to him, "If you really are the Son of God, save yourself from the cross." But Jesus knew he had to die to forgive his people for their sins. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land. 3 hours later, Jesus took his last breath and finally died. At that very moment, the curtain in the temple that separated the priests from God's holy place tore in two. A soldier watching the whole thing said, "This man truly was the Son of God." Then a righteous man named Joseph came and placed Jesus' body in a tomb. 3 days passed, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body and found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. "Don't be afraid," said an angel. "He is not here. He is risen." At this, the woman remembered that Jesus had told them that he would rise again on the third day.
Woohoo!
And ran to go tell the disciples what they had seen and heard.
Huh? Hey-o!
Ah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life.
Wow, what a story. So not only did Jesus die for our sins, but he came back for us. And why is that important? It's important because Jesus is who helps us get through all our tough days. When we really struggle, Jesus is the one who loves us and protects us and helps us to live a life in which we can wake up one day in heaven with God and Jesus and everybody we've ever known that loved Jesus. We get to spend an eternity together. How cool is that? Well, that's our Easter Sunday video for you guys. But we're not just going to leave you there. The fun part we had and you know, what some of the things I heard from a lot of you kids last week was how much fun you had listening to the worship songs. And in fact, there was one lady, Miss Josie, who wished there were more. So we've actually added another worship song just for you, Josie. So we have two worship songs just to close out our Easter Sunday video. So let's get some more dancing on. Let's celebrate Easter together. So let's stand up and let's do some dances. And I don't know if this is dancing or karate chops, but hey, it's Easter Sunday. Let's have some fun. All right, so we're going to listen to our last two songs. And then you get to go back to eating your chocolate and praising and loving on Jesus and telling people about the story of Easter to anybody who asks you. And now you know. So when they ask you, you can tell them because we saw it today. All right, so who's ready for our last two worship songs? You guys are. All right, well, with that being said, let's jump right in. Here we go. Let's praise the Lord together.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord.
Wow, what a cool song. All right, well, that concludes our Sunday service, our Easter Sunday service for you guys. I miss you guys, but before we say goodbye, I'm going to leave you with this. I'm going to leave you with one more song because I heard from somebody, Miss Josie, who said she wanted more music. And that's what we're going to do because music is what makes us smile. And it's music is worship and music. And worship is so important. So here you go. Are you ready for one last song? I'm ready. Let's do it. I just want to say happy Easter, everybody, and we'll see you next week.
When my world feels like it's shaking, when my
Happy Easter, everybody. I'll see you guys next week. And don't forget to tell somebody today that Jesus loves you. All right. I miss you guys. I can't wait to see you. But hey, I'll see you next week. Happy Easter.